Parental discretion is advised.
Find yourself in the Beachview area of Pittsburgh? Check out the official pizza of this show, Slice on Broadway, sharing an abnormal obsession with pizza we can relate to. Check them out at sliceonbroadway.com and tell them this show sent you.
Hey guys, are you enjoying the Wrestling Mayhem Show? Are you finding value in these conversations? Do you want to support it so we can become even bigger? Check out patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow.
Want to have your business or podcast featured on the show? Contact us at info@sorgatronmedia.com. Subject line, advertising. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the Mayhem Studios in Pittsburgh, PA. I am Sorgatron, at Sorgatron on the Twitters, and we're ready to talk about professional wrestling as we have been since 2006. It's a Wrestling Mayhem Show, and with me on the line, my compatriot, he experienced the PodCamp Pittsburgh. He presented as a professional podcaster and such. He's Papa Lunchbox from the Papa Lunchbox Central over there, Panel Riot headquarters. How you doing, sir?
Good. I'm real good. It's true. I did go to PodCamp. I did present a couple of things. I invaded your live awesome cast, which went pretty well. And I encourage you all to listen to this week's Panel Riot. I am examining, once again, three number one issues. X-Men number one from, I think, the 60s. X-Force number one from the 90s. Oh, boy. And Sex Criminals from just last year.
Nice. I picked up some books that you recommended, some Batman books from the library. So I was very excited about that. Also, I missed you last week. I missed not having something on my feed last week.
It's true. It was a rough week. But this week's episode is going to be extra long. Nice. Because X-Force was super bad. But do look forward to a future episode with Sorg in which we discuss Battle for the Cowl.
We will. I thought you were going to talk about the one we recorded already, but no.
Nope. That's probably not going to be till like March. So.
Well, holy shit.
What?
Okay. Oh, he's got long-term plans for this podcast.
After we're done recording, ask me and I'll explain it all.
Okay. I can't wait to hear this. Also with us from Poughkeepsie, New York is Mad Mike. How you doing, sir?
I'm still scratching my head about the panel, right?
still recovering. But,
yeah, I'm here. I'm having fun, being awesome, and I'm ready to talk about some wrestling.
Awesome, bam. Awesome. Also with us, Bobby, are you with us? Okay, so Bobby, we don't have video from you.
I'm here. I wanted
oh,
to,
there he is.
I wanted to enter via Crow.
Bobby. It's Bob. Yes. I thought it was Sting.
No, I do have a white face like Sting, but that's not makeup. It's my paleness. So.
Because there's no sun in Johnstown, PA, where he
there
hails from.
No sun. Just rain and lots of flood.
Yes, lots of water. He's kind of pruny.
And apparently snow tomorrow.
Oh, damn. Like I said, this is your Wrestling Mayhem Show. We're here every Tuesday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Time at live.sorgatronmedia.com. You can find out more about us over at wrestlingmayhemshow.com. And please subscribe to us on Stitcher, Spreaker, Stitcher, YouTube, iHeartRadio. And more specifically, you know, I kind of said, you know, make sure you comment and share the show. Definitely share the show, of course. And we have some friends that have shared the show this week. We'll be getting to in a moment. But please also, iTunes. Even if you don't listen to us on iTunes, look up the Wrestling Mayhem Show on iTunes and at least put a rating in. Helps us greatly. It's something I learned from PodCamp, even though, because how many places just scrape that feed from iTunes? So if you're rating and helping us out there on iTunes, that's going to help the show greatly. It's kind of the hub where everybody else gets us from normally. And otherwise, just share the show. Let people know you're digging it or what you're digging from the show. Some crazy shit that Mad Mike says this week as he's drinking a water and does a ventriloquist thing. I'm sorry, you're off the side and I see you like eating and drinking and you're like directly in front of me, so it's really messing with me.
I was about to start singing, but then you threw to me and I was drinking at the same time, so I
yes.
do
don't sing and drink.
No, don't Sorg, do that. Don't do that.
Sorg, we want everybody to rate, review, and subscribe.
Yes, I'll do all that stuff, please. It helps out. And just tell a friend. You can also drop us a line. You can participate in the show at that email address at
Good Times!
good times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com or that the hotline of 412-206-WMS0. It's been about a month since we've heard anybody in the voice line. So please, especially your holiday weekend, especially with the thankful stuff we're going to be talking about later in the show, please let us know your thoughts on wrestling. The year in wrestling is starting to, time to start kind of thinking about that. And let us know what your thoughts. You also hit us up.
Here's what I want people to do. You're going to be sitting down at Thanksgiving dinner with your family. I want you to describe a wrestling storyline to your grandmother. I don't care what storyline it is. You can talk about Ethan Carter. You can talk about The Authority. You can talk about the Bellas. I want you to describe a wrestling storyline to your grandmother and then have her call in and have her tell us her thoughts about that wrestling storyline.
And then call us on the voicemail when you're tripping on that tryptophan.
Yes.
All right. All right. You can also hit us up at Mayhem Show on the Twitters and, of course, Facebook, Watson. Google+.
Watson.
What?
Watson.
Hey. What? Your dog. Your cat's here.
Your dog.
Your dog Watson. Cat's here.
Watson's here to say hello.
Hello.
Hi, boy.
Hello.
Anyways, and also please support us as I said at the top of the show at Patreon, WrestlingMayhemShow.com/Patreon, just like the WrestlingRevolution.com that's been supporting us for months, and Bo Diggity.
Woo!
Yes. And hey, it's contest time. We had, and let me pull up here, make sure nobody else popped in here. But we had a contest this last week as we've been trying to do these weekly contests for participation. This week, the prize is Best of AJ Styles in the IWC Volume 2. Some great matches with him here in Pittsburgh in the area. Some great, great matches that you're not going to see on TV and a lot of other places. That's a digital download we're going to be sending out to our winner this week. And your task was to tweet about the show. Tell other people about the show and use the hashtag GetWMS to do that. Now we had, of course, we had a post by I believe if I'm correct connecting this is Dustin Mr. DRG underscore WIR on the Twitters and he tweeted out, so you think you're witty, a wrestling fan, and sexy as hell? Highly doubt it unless you're listening to At Mayhem Show. Thank you for that shout out there. And also, Mainstream Matt used the hashtag, but
I don't know if we can call him our friend in the mainstream media anymore because he uses hashtags like.
Definitely not social media.
He used the hashtag, but he didn't tell anybody to listen to the show that I can see. He mostly just kind of attached us in other tweets, just that he was tweeting anyways to like Triple H and Vince McMahon. So just for the quantity of using the hashtag, I'm going to go ahead and give both these guys the prize this week. So both you guys are going to get a link here as soon as I get a chance for Best of AJ Styles Volume 2. So please enjoy that, courtesy of PittsburghWrestling.com and the International Wrestling Cartel at IWCWrestling.com. They got a big show coming up this month if you're in the Pittsburgh area. I believe it's December 13th with Matt Hardy taking on Big League John McChesney, a friend of the show. So go check all that out. Now, what I want you guys to do this week, and let's see, your prize. You know what? I think your prize is actually going to be the
$1 million.
No, we're definitely not doing that. Oh, that's okay. Definitely not okay. Something we can do here.
WWE Network free please, for November.
Please, Bobby, don't. Please, Bobby, don't.
I'm sorry.
This week, you know
hypothetical
what?
Hypothetical dollars.
You know what? It's Thanksgiving. We're going to be talking about what we're thankful for coming up here. So here's a big one. Here's a show that just came out. RWA Salute to the Troops 2. It's a, you know, we're talking about what we're thankful for, and Salute to the Troops 2 was a dedication to our troops, to the military, and it was a big show, a fun show that we got to do last month, and featuring.
It was a big show.
No, that's not featuring, of course.
It was a big bad show to sort
of. Let me get through the segment, featuring of course Hurricane Shane Helms in a great main event match, a great three-way match for number one contendership, our friends in Generation Dead taking on Ohio's for Killers, in an awesome tag match, some women's wrestling, and a great cruiserweight match with Sanjay Dutt and Shane Andrews. So definitely worth the price of admission there, which will be free if you use the hashtag WMS Thanksgiving and let us know during this week, before the next we convene here next Tuesday. Tell us what you're thankful for in professional wrestling. Tell us what you're thankful for, what's happened, what you've been entertained by, or has professional wrestling bought you anything, like friends or anything like that. Please let us know at Mayhem Show and hashtag WMS Thanksgiving for a free copy of RWA Salute to the Troops 2, and we'll announce some winners out of that next week. So please check that out.
Could you pass the potatoes?
No, we're not having Thanksgiving right
here,
now.
Bobby. Oh, here, Bobby.
I can't fax you.
Wait, the regular or sweet?
Regular. I don't like sweet.
Can I have pudding first?
You don't like sweet. God damn it, no. So you can't have your pudding.
We're getting the show with our fan interaction, as we love to do. We have an email, and I believe DJ Lunchbox wants to kick us off with this.
It's true, but I have a problem before we start this. Bobby, did you say you don't like sweet potatoes?
I do not like sweet potatoes.
What is wrong with you? They're potatoes and they're sweet.
It's been real fun having you on the show, Bobby. But
no, ma'am, I don't like yams.
All right, you can stay. Wrestling Mayhem Show. It's your number one WWE hater here, Zero2K. So we had a Survivor Series on Sunday, and for the first time in a long time, I decided to watch a full episode of Raw.
Oh, poor Zero.
Your timing is poor. To start off, SS was a bit of a waste of time. One match show felt like watching Sunday Night Raw. Aside from the main event, all matches and segments felt like they belong at Raw or SmackDown. Main event was quite good. I liked how everyone got eliminated aside from Ryback, who only took two moves. Sting. Didn't like. I understand this was done for cheap pops. Mike, get your fucking cursor out of the middle of the email. It's covering up my shit. I understand this was done for cheap pops and to sell subscriptions, but still, the execution was all wrong. Sting came out to a song no one recognizes. He walked down the ramp instead of doing the blackout thing, no bat in hand. The stare down was long. And I guess we were to assume that Ziggler, Seth, Joey, Jamie, and Steph were all knocked out silly meanwhile. But the thing that I really hated was that Sting dragged Ziggler over Rollins. I kind of felt that it took a little bit off of Ziggler's win. Ziggler should had dragged himself for the pin. Then I watched Raw, and boy, is your boy D-Bry a dick. He laughs at Hunter and Steph that were just fired and crying. He forces Rusev and Lana to pledge allegiance to a flag that is not theirs. He completely bluffs when promising a battle royal. This Brian kid is a dick, and his wife too.
One second. How can you call this face a dick? For the audio listeners, I have Daniel Bryan's pop vinyl figure, and he's mostly beard. But how can you call it that? How could you call this face a dick?
Hold on, Bobby, hold it up again.
Yes.
Ooh, you're a dick.
Oh.
That's how. That's
how.
Daddy's
gonna go away now.
Harsh words.
I faced him into the corner though.
Just to cap it off and not make this longer, Triple H was right. I'm already crying for Hunter to come back because you know Hornswoggle got his hands on another computer again. Which I asked you all, what other GMs / authority figures from the past would make you want Hunter and Steph back? Laters, kiddos. Remember to watch Lucha Underground and soon enough, New Japan Pro Wrestling on US TV. Zero out. Well, guys, what other GM/ authority figures from the past would make you want Hunter and Steph back?
I got one. Mike Adam Lee.
Ooh.
You're making me crazy.
But see, Adam Lee was at least kind of funny with how bad he was.
Yeah, but he was bad.
I'm just trying to think of someone
who was... Like... He was Jeff Harvey bad.
I'm going to go with Palmer Cannon. Palmer Cannon was a non-entity. Just
I don't even remember him.
Exactly. That's exactly
like, I remember
my
the
point.
Name, but I can't put
he,
a face.
He was
to
the
it.
Network executive that brought on the new talent initiative of SmackDown. And just like it was like a piece of plywood. Just a piece of plywood reacting off of Teddy Long dancing. it was just absolutely horrible. Like, if they brought back Palmer Cannon, I mean, Grant, I already don't like the anonymous GM coming back, but...
Yeah, that's no good. That was super annoying.
I don't even a little bit remember this guy.
The only way the anonymous GM thing will be good is if it's Solomon Crow and it's the hacker gimmick.
I'm thinking. Oh, go ahead.
I genuinely can't remember this guy's name, but I hated him. And it's the guy that Eamon is like has a boner for.
That is a lot of people.
I know.
John Laurinaitis?
John Laurinaitis. That's who it was.
Big Johnny.
People power.
Yeah, yeah. I hated him like poison. I would pick Stephanie and Triple H over him any day.
Now, if you're here, and you're sitting there, it's people power.
Fucking. Oh. I'm sorry. The most boring thing in the world just happened, and it was John Laurinaitis.
That red suit, though.
The one thing about this anonymous GM thing that they could do that I would enjoy the hell out of, if it's Triple H and Stephanie trying to use that power to get back into control.
That would be awesome.
That would be amazing. Or Bobby.
They go under the ring and it's Triple H sitting down there with a computer.
That's way too smart. They're never going to do that. That's brilliant. Sorg, what about you?
Anonymous GM, so I guess I'm going to get it.
So you already want.
So I'm already done with this. So oh geez. So Vicky was GM. SmackDown had some rough ones, didn't they?
SmackDown had some good ones. SmackDown had Paul Heyman and Steph.
That's true. That's true.
Wasn't Ric Flair a SmackDown GM at one point?
Ric Flair as part owner was horrible.
Teddy Long, it's awesome. Making tag team matches playa.
Challenging people to wrestle The Undertaker.
man. Jack Tunney.
Jack Tunney was a non-entity.
Actually, Roddy Piper was really a horrible commissioner.
I don't think I was around for that. Isn't that the one that led to him and Goldust?
He took over right after Jack Tunney, or right after Gorilla Monsoon.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Because Gorilla Monsoon got attacked by Vader.
R.I.P. Jack Tunney and Gorilla Monsoon.
Yes.
Yeah, respect. Respect to both, actually.
I had the Jack Tunney WWE trading card.
Nice.
Wow.
Very nice.
Yeah, I don't know where it is now. I probably have it somewhere. But I did have that trading card.
Wow.
Also had the Red Rooster.
Thanks, Zero, for that email. There was no other questions for that, right?
No, that was
okay. Awesome. So let's know. It actually is the chat room. Let me double check. Is the chat room doing this? Gar has pointed out that we had tag team playa Teddy mm-hmm. Long. But yeah, if you have any bad GMs you can think of, make sure to hit us up at AwesomeCast. Oh no, what show is this?
AwesomeCast.
At Mayhem Show on Twitter. And let us know there or on the Facebook group. So, hey, I want to give a quick shout out to Slice on Broadway, our friends that are keeping us in pizza on Tuesday nights for those guests that come in here for a lot of the shows. And not you guys, although Riz is coming in sooner or later. I know that. I think we talked them into it to
Listen,
experience.
We got a Christmas episode coming up, students, so I'll be there.
We
so
do.
Could you pass the pizza?
Yeah, I'll fax you a piece. But you check them out, sliceonbroadway.com, if you're in the Pittsburgh area. They're down on Broadway Avenue here in Beachview in the South Hills of Pittsburgh. And, of course, you can check them out in Carnegie, PA at their new location. I saw them putting pictures up of them putting up the Christmas lights at their location down there. Main Street, Carnegie, PA, on your way out to – you see the exit on the way out. Miss all the construction there on the way out to the airport if you're in the Pittsburgh area. Go check them out. Follow them on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. To get hungry. Holy crap. Those pictures.
I'm
up all night to get hungry. We're up all night to get hungry.
So thanks to them, sliceonbroadway.com. So with that, hey, there was a pay-per-view-ish that nobody paid for, or we paid for, or I'm really confused at this point. So we had the Survivor Series. We mentioned Raw. Raw was a little last night. Maybe we'll talk about that a little bit later. Or as a whole. Check out the WWE Raw wrap-up for Mad Mike and mine's responses to Raw last night. I remember, what was the one thing that we got out of that? Nikki Bella's t-shirt.
Mm-hmm. Always a bridesmaid, never give up.
That's right. That's right. That pretty much sums her up. If you watch Total Divas, but Survivor Series, we had, well, first let's talk about like everything except that main event. Anything stick out for you, on that show, aside from the main Survivor Series team, match that changed everything, Sunday night?
Tag team match.
The tag team match. The tag team match was a fatal four way. Of course, we got new champions with Ms. Dow. I guess
Ms. Dow was amazing as usual.
That was wonderful.
Him flipping over the ring, just like flipping everywhere. It's amazing. He's gonna hurt himself, but it's amazing.
Him running in the ring, taking atomic drop on air.
Yeah.
Was the funniest thing I've ever seen.
Now he has the dual fake belt, the toy belts.
It's so funny because as a tag team, this shouldn't work. Because as mm-hmm. the Miz is getting beat up in there, Sandow is like falling off the apron in response instead of reaching for a tag, instead of doing a run in to help his partner. So as a tag team, this should not be functional. Yet it is, and it's the most amazing thing ever. It defies all tag team logic. Yeah.
Think about it, he's always trying to distract opponents.
That's true. That's true.
And he's not interfering, so he's not risking a disqualification. But he's coming in and he's throwing opponents off their game.
It's a new tactic.
Actually, kind of the best tag team.
Have you ever in WWE or WWF history seen anything like this?
No.
It's completely original, and I love it.
Yeah.
I mean, the only thing that came close-ish, I guess, but not really, was when they had multiple doinks. And I'm not talking like the Bushwhackers in Mission. I mean, there was one doink, and then he went under the ring and came out, there's another doink. That's the only thing that's even remotely close to this. But it's so, outside of the box that it's shocking that it's being WWE and not like Jakara.
Did any of you guys watch the pre-show?
Yes.
Did you see the promo that they cut backstage where Miz Dow was holding the mirror, the frame around his face, and he was the mirror? But the brilliant thing was they made it look like Miz was talking to himself in a mirror, but he was actually talking to Sandow, psyching him up for the match, and he's like, I wasn't nodding at the end of the promo. It was so perfect. It was amazing.
It was fantastic.
It was great.
I love, like, these are two guys that were just in obscurity for the longest time. Mm-hmm. Miz was on a Jericho podcast a bit ago, probably I think they recorded around SummerSlam, one of the tours they did. And it's when Justin Roberts, wasn't it? The announcer, they were both on there together. And he was talking about how, like, he left for the movie and he was like, he knew he needed a reboot. Right. He said he was almost in that phase. He's like, man, I need to get injured or something so I can leave and come back and reboot. Right. Mm-hmm. And that's what led to this Hollywood character, which led to in turn Sandow, which is another guy that we're like, he's impersonating people. Where the hell are they going to go with this? And, you know, he just kind of landed in the spot. Right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
And they
guarantee they didn't plan on this going past the title match with Sheamus.
They threw it against the wall and it stuck.
Oh, it stuck. It stuck big time. And now this is the most that and it also blew my mind that I'm watching. I think it was actually Monday night I was watching, and I realized that we have Cody Rhodes and Damian Sandow, who were like, you know, a year ago fighting over Money in the Bank. Mm-hmm. And here they are in these weird alternative characters. And still fighting each other and being tremendous with each other, by the way, when they're in there. Yeah. Just everything. We've talked about it in the past couple of years, this renaissance of the tag team division. And I know we kind of lulled out here a few months ago, but I think everything still delivers at a pay-per-view. And I think we're getting the most creative and interesting stuff that we have in years.
Even Los Matadors were entertaining in that match.
Oh, yeah,
too.
Certainly. That they're not, they're, and they let them be kind of a seen as a contender. by giving them a win the week before. And their characters. And also realize how many, I said siblings mistakenly, but I realized the Matadors are actually cousins upon further Wikipedia-ing. But, you know, but that's another thing. We have two brother tag teams, you know. Of the four that were in there, and the other one family, like, and that's really cool. And I think that's maybe adding to that dynamic as well. On top of that, on the tag team thing, did anybody watch the Uso special on WWE Network?
No, not yet.
It's actually very good. It's only a half an hour. It's like a quick thing they did. And I love that they're able to take that, you know, I mean, so people are like, well, why do the Usos get a special, right? But the Usos are a pretty significant tag team, but been on a roster for a while. They get the tag belts. They had that lineage. There's a lot of discussion with, Reigns, who grew up with them and played football with them. So that was really cool to see. And of course, Rikishi Fatu, as part of that too. And getting into like why they do things the way they do and the dance and everything and how they got to WWE. It's like a mini version of how awesome that Shield special was. I love these little things that they're able to do in WWE Network. So, to give a little bit to even like the smaller, you know, card guys like this, but really they are wildly popular, especially kids and stuff, you know? So,
Before we get too far away from the pay-per-view, there was something else that I really enjoyed. Mm-hmm. And that was the, Bray Wyatt, other guy match. Dean Ambrose.
Other guy's my favorite wrestler.
I'm not thinking straight. Yeah. Right. Dean Ambrose, Bray Wyatt match was great.
I agree with you, but I think most people were disappointed in that and the way it turned out.
I think it kind of fell flat for me.
They're setting up the next match for him.
Yeah, I thought it was fun. I thought it was brutal and it was enjoyable.
Why did he bring out a ladder?
Table, ladders, and chairs.
That's not an answer for that question.
Well, okay,
it's his way of challenging him to a TLC match.
I admit it's kind of weird. And it was like obviously this is all set up for a TLC match right off the bat. But it was weird that he climbed the ladder and then stopped.
Yeah, it almost seemed like they used this match of Survivor Series as a preview for the people who bought the network for free.
That's basically what they did.
Yeah, precisely.
Because they announced it that same night. Oh, wait, we got this next
which
month.
Which never happens at a pay-per-view.
Yeah.
I mean, there was a lot of like, well, this feels like an episode of Raw a little bit, guys. We started with a promo. But to be fair, I looked it up. The year before also started with a promo from the Authority.
Mm-hmm.
So there's that. Because I think there's something with Daniel Bryan was going on. So whatever match there. One of his screw over matches he had for the championship, I think. So
I miss Raw Roulette.
What was a Raw Roulette?
I said I miss Raw Roulette. I just want to put that out there.
Yeah.
Cyber Monday this Monday.
Cyber Monday, not apparently what we think it is, I guess. Yeah.
Everybody's gonna shop on WWE.com.
Yeah, that's what it's just gonna be sales. It's gonna be Alex Riley going nuts until you go to WWE shop the whole time.
And then posing against Booker T and Byron Saxton.
and then Booker T telling us about the barbecue in St. Louis still.
I totally thought that was gonna be an ad for JR's barbecue sauce, but they completely ignored it.
I guess so. It's a weird relationship they have there, isn't it? Also from the Survivor Series, this weird sexual tension thing of our surrogate John Cena, Daniel Bryan, CM Punk threesome that's been happening.
What was that?
As we discussed last night in the wrap-up, Daniel Bryan, John Cena, and CM Punk are all Eskimo brothers now.
Yeah, they need to sign up.
EB.
And then go to EB. EBDB, the WWE EBDB BNB. Nice. If you're a fan of the league,
solid.
That is what they need to build.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
That is if there was create a storyline mode in WWE 2K15, that would be the storyline I'd create. Mm-hmm. The EBDB WWE.
Yeah. I want to move on to the main event now.
No word of it.
I feel like with the really violent match with Dean Ambrose and Bray Wyatt, and the kissing with the ladies and all of that, fun jazz, and Sting, and of course, and Sting, they knew.
And Sting.
Who they, they knew who their audience was, and they absolutely were trying to get people to stay subscribed.
Yeah.
Past the 3 months.
Like, sign up for the network. We have ladies kissing.
Yeah. Yeah, they're not interested in the kids. They're not trying to get the kids to stay subscribed after SummerSlam. They're trying to get us.
Can we say we're approaching the PG-13 era? Maybe. It's like a little pushing the boundaries a little bit more.
Yeah, yeah, and they've been doing that little bit. I think they've been doing that little and little, and kind of seeing if they can settle back into it.
I have a legit question about Raw last night.
Okay,
sure.
Did Big Show say shit?
No.
Didn't.
No, I was listening. No. It almost sounded like it, but
it sounded like
he just spits a lot when he talks.
Okay,
he does.
Okay.
He does.
I'm sorry. Go on.
Anyways, let's touch on Sting, that main event. By the way, I think it was the most enthralling and roller coastering. The pictures I was receiving of DJ Lunchbox watching the match were
shocked.
Tremendous.
Shocked by Big Show's betrayal.
Oh, jeez.
Hashtag straw boner.
I can't remember the last time that they delivered like legit surprises like that. Starting off with Big Show punching out Mark Henry, leading to Big Show punching out John Cena. The way Rusev got taken out. The fantastic performance by Dolph Ziggler. Then down to the I've seen this referred to as an Attitude Era ending with everybody getting involved, referees getting knocked down, and Sting coming in.
Mm-hmm.
Great. It was great. I can't say enough good things about it.
It's the best elimination tag match I've seen in years on Survivor Series.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Oh, certainly.
And like Eamon said in the Facebook group, it made sense for Big Show to hit Mark Henry and eliminate him first because they had their grudge.
Mm-hmm.
Got that out of the way. And then Big Show turning on Cena made sense because, you know, he before the authority tried to take away his job and take away his mortgage. He had a mortgage payment up and stuff like that. There was something about a mortgage. But
yeah, there was.
He didn't want to lose his job, basically, is what it, and he picked the authority. You know, and he thought they were going to win. It was looking like they were going to win. Dolph Ziggler was the only one left. He was on the outside of the ring. What's a giant to do?
Big Show really hasn't ever watched a John Cena match, though, has he?
But he took out John Cena, though.
Hear that.
Because Cena got taken out like a bitch.
Took out John Cena.
But then the only thing I can... like why Big Show may have sided with the authority. John Cena is always used to overcoming the odds. It was 3-on-3 when Big Show punched Cena in the face, so he didn't think John Cena could overcome the evens.
Sure.
I think that's finally like where Big Show was like, oh, well, this isn't a handicap match, so John Cena can't do this by himself.
What kind of a friend is Daniel Bryan to put everybody in a handicap match last night?
Yeah.
I mean, sorry. I don't want to keep going back to Raw, but my short-term memory kind of...
I was... After Cena got eliminated, it bothered me that they kept calling it Team Cena when it was just Dolph Ziggler. Yeah. And barely just Dolph Ziggler.
Barely Dolph Ziggler.
Yeah.
It was like Dolph Z. He couldn't even get the whole Ziggler out because he was just...
Well, apparently JBL can't get the entire Ziggler out either.
Oh, never could.
JBL.
Ziggler.
There's an L in there for a reason.
There's an L in there for many reasons.
So what do you guys... How do you guys rate this? So let's say you weren't somebody that jumped on way back, as most of us did in February, right? Say if you've been holding out, and yes, LB, I know your situation too. But you say you jumped on
the entire show. Doesn't know my situation.
No. No. I'm just saying. Okay. No, we don't want to get into it. But let's say you've been a subscriber, you've been experienced this whole time. Say that wasn't the case, and you had jumped on this free month. How do you rate how they've kind of represented the network? Do you think for those people that did jump onto the free this month, that they'll be sticking around after what they've seen?
If they jumped on for Survivor Series, and then they saw Survivor Series and they saw Sting, and then they're like, "Oh, that was pretty great. I should watch Raw." They immediately changed their minds about whether or not they're going to stay on.
Yeah.
So you're saying they didn't follow through past, like, they had the plan and they had the network and Survivor Series, and now it's.
Yeah, because it's not about hooking people with specific on-network content. I think it's about being an overall good product.
Mm-hmm.
And so while the end of Survivor Series was very thought-provoking and exciting, none of that carried over on Raw.
No, Raw wasn't real bad.
Or do we kind of show that the good stuff is actually on the network now?
Because yes, I gotta say, you would never know that if you watch Raw.
No, but if you participated in the free month, you got to see the stuff that isn't Raw. You got to see the NXT, the ECW stuff, the Survivor Series, the stuff that isn't the product that is the diluted, why are we doing 3 hours on Monday night show with Larry the Cable Guy. You get to see this is like a whole other side of WWE that might be worth paying for.
But Sorg, they never plug NXT.
No.
They never, and they should. They plug Main Event, which is essentially a glorified Superstars most weeks. But they need to plug NXT. Like, show a match. Show some highlights from NXT. You have the best
they
people
have,
who can make video
they
packages
have
in the world.
Been showing them. They have been featuring them on Main Event, haven't they?
Yeah, they have.
Every once in a while,
Just Sami Zayn and Tyson Kidd. Which the Tyson one, Kidd's already on Raw.
The 1 week where they had an NXT match on Raw was great. I really feel like they should have like a feature match every week on Raw.
Yes.
Or at least once a month.
It's not
most
like
the
they're using
travel.
The time real productively.
Yeah, most of the guys travel with them anyway, especially at least the ones who are ready to come up. Mm-hmm. Like have an Ascension versus Matadors match on Raw. I'd sign up for that. That'd be fun. Because then you could show the Ascension being big badasses and like, hey, these guys are from NXT, our developmental channel that you can watch exclusively on the network. Or have Adrian Neville come out and challenge, like have a non-title match with the IC champion. You obviously can't do Rusev because Rusev won't be pinned. But have Neville sneak one in on Luke Harper, like with a distraction or something like that. You need to feature these people or have an NXT Women's Champion versus an NXT Divas versus WWE Divas Champion. Like, give me Charlotte versus AJ or Charlotte versus Nikki Bella. That'd be amazing.
Basically, what we're saying is anything is better than the dregs that you showed us Monday night.
Exactly. Exactly.
It was not good. And well, it was not entertaining. It was so bad that it just made us all fight with each other.
Yeah, yeah.
On that point, let's we'll be back in a moment to talk about what we are thankful for and not what we're not so, quite so thankful for right now in pro wrestling in general, because it is the Thanksgiving week, of course. But in the meantime, please check out PittsburghWrestling.com with some guys we dig locally. I mentioned the RWA Salute to the Troops, too. Again, remember the hashtag WMS Thanksgiving to let us know what you're thankful for this week for a chance to get that and check that out. But also, be sure to stay tuned here Friday. We're going to have a post over at SorgatronMedia.com. We'll be featuring a big discount code for the digital downloads over at PittsburghWrestling.com, as well as we're bringing back the $3 for $30 DVDs. If you're a DVD person, you can mix and match anything, any three DVDs. They range from about 10, 12 bucks to 15, plus shipping and handling. Of course, you'll be able to get them for $30 plus shipping. If you want to put some indie wrestling under the stocking, be sure to check that out. So tune in this Friday or sign up to the newsletter so you don't miss it. Go over to SorgatronMedia.com and PittsburghWrestling.com. Sign up for the newsletter and you still get a free digital download. IWC's 100th show featuring guys like AJ Styles, Christopher Daniels on it. A great collection. I think Delirious is on that too, remembering off the top of my head. A great, fantastic show. So go check that out, PittsburghWrestling.com. And we'll be right back with Remember When. Hey guys, welcome back. And again, please go check everything out at PittsburghWrestling.com this Friday for that Black Friday sale. All right, right now we're going to kind of step aside here and do something a little different than what we're usually doing here. Yeah, we like to have fun on the show and everything, but we just wanted to acknowledge real quick, and we'll talk about this, have a little bit more in depth on the Indie Mayhem show if you want to check that out this week. But we want to acknowledge the passing of a good friend here at Sorgatron Media. Jack Bolson passed away in a car accident, actually, this past Friday morning. From our understanding, swerved, went off the road, was ejected from the car, and was found about 7 in the morning. He was a guy that worked with us a lot with our productions here with the IWC, with RWA, with other video stuff. He's 28 years old when he passed. So we just wanted to give a moment to acknowledge him, and especially in this holiday season where we need to be thankful for those that are around us and everything, you know, kind of acknowledging how, you know, fleeting it can be. Like I said, we'll talk about this a little in depth, but our thoughts and prayers from all of us here at Sorgatron Media Wrestling Mayhem Show, and I know it's been extended from both IWC and the RWA as well. Thoughts and prayers go out to his family and friends. But like I said, we'll talk a little bit more about that more appropriately on the Indie Mayhem Show. But I just want to touch on that real quick, and please, if you knew him on Facebook or anything, there's been a lot of people saying a lot of great things, including friends of our show, like Joe Dombrowski, and like I said, the feds, of course. So just wanted to put that out there. And as we're going into our next session, Remember When, actually we're replacing the Remember When a little bit. It's Thanksgiving. We like to acknowledge Thanksgiving a little bit, and tell us for, you know, it's what we're thankful in wrestling, right? So we got a year, you know, what something in the past year. We're in that year of review area here, or what has wrestling brought to you, or something like that. Tell us, please join us in the chat room. Of course, we're joined here on the line. Riz has joined us from here in Pittsburgh, and of course, Eamon.
Hey, from Bobby, are you done with the mashed potatoes? Can I have some?
I threw them away.
Oh,
Bobby, what the hell?
Why would you do that?
Dude, mashed potato pancakes the next day. What's wrong with you?
Do you at least have the stuffing? I mean, I'm kind of hungry over here.
I got stuffing. I got stuffing.
I'm sorry, I finished.
Could you just imagine if we all actually got together and did something of a Thanksgiving dinner amongst this crew?
Sorg, do we even have the gravy right now? Can I just have the bowl of gravy and just
John Goodman drank it.
I thought we were saving that gravy for a wrestling match.
Bobby said that with such confidence.
John Goodman drank it.
Can't have it.
He was very angry about that.
Wow. So, guys, who wants to go first? What are you thankful in the world of professional wrestling right now?
Oh, and Eamon's also here.
I did say I was starting to say it, and you started stepping on it with that joke. So I'm sorry. Eamon has joined us from San Antonio, Texas.
Hi, thank you. Double introduction. Double the fun.
Yes. All right, co-host with the Indie Mayhem.
I've got something, Sorg.
All right, LB, what are you thankful for in the world of professional wrestling?
Sunday night when we were watching the pay-per-view, I was at the Carlins house with Riz the Fur, Matt Carlins, and Dan Carlins, and it was right towards the end of the main event, and we were all having so much fun. We were laughing and shouting, and you know, there had been all these surprises, and you know, it was a little quiet spot. You know what I mean? People were selling their injuries, and I just kind of sat back and thought, God, I fucking love wrestling so much, and I love it for these moments. I'm thankful for these moments where I don't know what's going to happen. It's, you know, the writing is good. It's unpredictable. You don't know who's going to win or what's going to happen next, and that's what I'm thankful for is the truly great moments of professional wrestling.
Awesome. Anybody else?
I guess I can do mine. I kind of be a jerk to not say that, you know, I'm thankful for, you know, being a part of wrestling now. That's been an amazing kind of ride. That's something I never really imagined in a million years, to participate in this wild affair, working for Inspired Pro Wrestling, for those that do not know. But that's, you know, working for them is what really opened my mind to what, you know, the business and all that stuff is kind of all about, and I've gotten to meet some really amazing people through it. Some people that really shifted my opinions on things and have sort of taught me great things about professional wrestling, but also just life in general. And that's something that is probably something I won't forget for a good while. So that's mine.
Awesome. I got one. Oh,
go ahead, Bobby.
I got one.
Go ahead, Bobby.
I'm thankful for good wrestling. We're living in an age. I watched 4 hours of wrestling on Thursday night. I watched 3 episodes of Lucha Underground on my Chromecast, on my TV from YouTube, because I don't have El Rey Network, but somebody luckily put it on YouTube, the entire episodes. I watched 3 of them in a row, and then I watched NXT right after it, and it was awesome, and I loved it. It made me appreciate Chavo Guerrero. I screamed at my TV when he was attacking the little person. I was like, he's so little, don't attack him, Chavo! I screamed that at my TV because I cared so much about the match.
Bobby, that is a solid 4 hours of wrestling.
It was great.
That is a solid 4 hours.
I loved it. I can't wait to watch the next 2 that I have to catch up on. But so good. Mil Mortes or whatever his name is.
Mil Mortes.
He's awesome. He's such a great character right now in there.
Bobby, did you tear up a little bit in his backstory? Because I know I did.
Not teared up, but I was
like a little
like he was like a little kid that got trapped in an earthquake, and he became Mil Mortes by just like being a badass little kid, and then he picked up a rock.
from the chat, Ciro's thankful that Bobby's watching Lucha Underground.
Yeah, awesome, awesome.
All right.
Don't attack little people, Chavo.
I'll say it.
Okay.
I'm thankful for the WWE Network.
Yeah.
Because
it's bringing me back to what I liked about wrestling. And it wasn't the Attitude Era. It wasn't stuff like that. I'm 27 years old, and I still get to see Bret Hart in his prime.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then
Mega Powers.
His downfall in his prime, but in his prime. But just watching that, watching the Mega Powers, watching WCW, watching how I got into wrestling, which was the Undertaker versus the Undertaker match at SummerSlam. And reliving how bad that match is now. Just having that thing, and it's best $9.99 a month I can spend. If anything I can say is it has the library to be the great thing that everybody wants it to be. And I love it. I love it. That's pretty much what I got.
Awesome. Also from the chat, Riz. I'm sorry, not Riz. What? I see a Z and an R, and I want to say the what? Riz. Hot Wheels RWA says he's thankful for working with great talent and learning a lot from some of the greats in the business, and also thankful friends like Sorg, Mad Mike, Eamon, Bobby LB, and Riz. Awesome.
Thank you, Hot Wheels.
Awesome. Thank
Why
you.
Am I last, Wheels? Why am I
last? Because you have a Z. In
because
your
name. You've only just recently experienced an RWA show.
You did it alphabetically, I think.
Well, I'm sorry. I didn't know that mothers are going to be pile-driven in RWA shows, or else I would have been there more, Sorg.
See, now there's an expectation that a mother has to go down every time that
Whoa.
She goes.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa, oh, yes. Wow.
Every time LB's there.
Whole different
Watch
shows.
Out, mothers. Watch out, mothers. It's time to go down. Watch out,
this
mothers.
Is a brand That's... new episode of Motherfucker.
I was just going to say that.
A literal.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Praise Jesus.
I'm thankful.
I don't get to go?
No, you.
Matt, Mike, what do you
just because
think?
I'm going doesn't well, mean we're done.
Going.
So wait, go, so I'm mixing goes. It up.
Okay, we usually close with you, Sorg. That's all I'm saying.
Jeez.
The Sorg's the closer.
I wanted so, to get one.
Main inning.
Okay. I'm thankful. You know, I realize because especially this year, I've really rejected football, for instance.
Yeah, fuck football.
and I've just like tried and just haven't failed to get into MMA, hockey, baseball to any extent, right? As much as like, you know, you guys, you know, Bobby Riz, I mean, you guys are always tweeting about it, and that's kind of I live vicariously through your excitement in those Let's instances go. Through the seasons. And Mikey Chachi and anybody else like that, right?
Who's Chachi?
What?
He's Chachi.
Who's Chachi? Anyways, I don't know what you're talking about. But then I have come to realize that, you know, and I'm like, well, I don't have my sporty thing that dudes are supposed to have, right? and then I realize pro wrestling is that sporty thing, right?
Yeah.
This is the thing that I. Much like, you know, that it's Sunday during this season, you can't do anything. It's like, it's Monday all year round. I'm doing this thing. It's a pay-per-view. I'm doing this thing. My wife has the understanding. And there's no argument. There's a little bit of a sigh, but there's a little argument where it's like, nope, it's wrestling tonight. Wow. Thankfully, she's into it. She's into it. So I'm also very thankful for my very understanding wife, who
she's right there, isn't she?
No, she's not right here. She's in bed. She's not even upstairs.
At him.
She's right behind you.
Holding
a wooden spoon.
and just mouthing, this is, guess where this is going.
Oh, Jesus.
Anyways.
I'm a good influence.
No, I'm thankful because she is a fan, and like, you know, we've talked about in the past on the show how her grandmother was a fan, and she grew up and she's a fan of Sting, and it was great to watch like replay the main event for her on Monday night and see her get excited about that. But obviously, I kind of experienced more wrestling than she really wants to. So she understands that and does get into a little bit and lets me have my way with the rest of it, right? So I'm thankful to that. I'm thankful I have my thing with wrestling that's been an outlet and really just, you know, spun into all of this, you know, this empire, this wonderful empire over here. So I think that's really cool. Mad Mike.
I'm gonna be thankful for the all the non-Raw and pay-per-view wrestling things that I can be involved with. Like, we have Lucha Underground. We have NXT. Mm-hmm. Yes, we even have Impact Wrestling. Mm-hmm. We have, I know this is particular to the Sorgatron Media, we have a wrestling game show, mm-hmm. for fuck's sake.
Which is hilarious, which is amazing, by the way. Now.
Thankful it's, for WrestlingDatabase.com.
It's so much fun to just play a fake Family Feud game about a fake sport with a fake champion. Like, it's just, and we have watch parties now for matches that we just randomly think of that we want to watch again and talk about. It's just so much, like, it's so good of a time to be a wrestling fan.
Mm-hmm.
Just in general, there is so much stuff out there to consume and to produce. Like, it's just such a great fucking time to be a wrestling fan, as much as we are befuddled by some of the things they do. there's so much more good than bad. It's just the bad is more fun to talk about because we can make snarky jokes about it.
Hashtag Larry the Cable Guy.
Yes!
Get her done.
Thank you, Bobby! Get her done!
Wow. Did I hit everybody? Everybody mentioned, right? I've got everybody from the chat room. Mm-hmm. Yep. All right. So let us know what you're thankful for. Hashtag WMS Thanksgiving. And you got a chance to win Salute to the Troops RWA2 with Hurricane Shane Helms, Sanjay Dett. Shane Douglas is on there too, by the way, and so much more. Great stuff. Great indie wrestling. Speaking of the Thanksgiving, of course, is the Black Friday. We already mentioned we're going to have a sale coming up at PittsburghWrestling.com this weekend. But also coming up, there's going to be a sale at ProWrestlingTees.com.
I love these sales, by the way.
20% off anything in ProWrestlingTees.com store. Use the coupon code starting, I believe it starts Thursday and runs through December 1st. So Thanksgiving through December 1st. Use the code Black Friday and you'll get 20% off any shirt. This is the perfect time to jump in there, guys. Get your shirts, ProWrestlingTees.com/WMS. And support the show and save a couple bucks while you're at it. Some great designs by the great Alex Cars. Our Good Times at Wrestling Mayhem Show, Good Times, Fast Times style shirt. Thank you, guys. Our property and WMS shirt. All that kind of stuff. Please go check it out and get 20% off. Regularly $19.99. And you'll get a little bit of discount off there. Support the show. ProWrestlingTees.com/WMS. And go on there. Guys like Asylum that we just talked to a couple weeks ago over on the Indie Mayhem Show, the guy that stood out from that NXT Performance Center video that came out from a few weeks ago. He's on there with a whole bunch of great shirts. I've seen a few of them at the shows. I love the Batman Asylum style shirt he has that he's been wearing around. So go check it out, ProWrestlingTees.com/WMS over the weekend. Use that coupon code Black Friday. And we'll be tweeting that all weekend so you don't miss it. So with that, you know who's thankful for a new television deal? Is Impact Wrestling.
Are they?
Let's talk about that. Let's talk about it. First of all, the deal is the announcement is Impact Wrestling. I'll see if I can get the wording here. For those that haven't seen what the deal is yet. Destination America, which is apparently owned by, I believe, Discovery Networks.
They have shows about bacon.
What? They have shows about bacon.
They have shows about bacon.
Okay.
The United States of Bacon.
And it's an awesome show about bacon.
Awesome. Yes.
And stuff like American Hauntings, stuff like that. But Discovery Communications acquires exclusive broadcast rights to top professional wrestling league TNA Impact Wrestling for Destination America. Ideally, this sounds like they could. This is more than just the opportunity to do Impact Wrestling. There's been speculation maybe something like a British boot camp can happen, be brought over or adapted for America, perhaps. Some other opportunities for them. of course, the first issue is Destination America is not on your basic cable package, much like what was it, El Rey Network for Lucha Underground is not on everybody's package.
on my package.
I got it on my package.
Children.
Well, first of all, Mike, you guys, we'll touch on Mike and Riz because you guys have been
around.
Mike and Riz, you talk about this every week with the midweek Night Wars podcast
the
that we do.
Midweek,
which is changing. I don't know. I'm curious to see what you do for the show for the next month.
We're gonna do Lucha Underground versus NXT.
That's fine. That's great. That's great. I love that you're just gonna clean up of everything else happening in pro wrestling at this point.
You're welcome, Sorg.
It's great. Yeah. No, it's filling a nice hole.
We cover the shows you don't want to.
Exactly. Exactly. But it's on Destination America. First, you know, Mike and Riz, what is your impressions of is it good that they it's good that they got a deal, right? It's good that they're still on a cable network. But how do you weigh this deal? Obviously it's not as good as Spike as far as penetration.
now you're just doing it on purpose.
The third of penetration in your package, Sorg.
Sorg is titillating our audience.
The question is, the question really is if Destination America will allow TNA wrestling fans, you know, the people that want to see more men wrestle. That didn't work. Well,
that didn't work. That's good.
I feel bad.
That's good. I'll give you points for that.
You shouldn't.
You know, Mad Mike, please take us in a new direction and let us know your thoughts on this move.
I think it's obviously great for the wrestlers. First of all, the talent. TNA still does have some of the best talent in the world.
Mm-hmm. And Mr. Anderson.
Aw, don't be hard on Mr. Anderson.
He's not the worst.
He's not wrong
either. He once flushed a summer sausage down my friend's toilet.
What?
That was amazing.
What does that have to do with anything?
Mad Mike, continue.
What a strange thing to say.
Let Mad Mike do this.
What a strange sentence to say.
All right. Show title, Bobby Summer Sausage. Anyway, I think it's great. It's great for the talent. I'm a little, as weird as it is for me to say this, I'm a little upset that they're going to be filming in New York City again.
That is weird for you to say. You live in...
Wow. Yes! I know! I literally got... I went to the show last time.
Because you have free tickets.
Yes! Thank you, friend of the show, Dave Lagana. I'd love another set, please. But anyway, I got really tired of the Manhattan Center. I got really, really tired of it.
Especially since they filmed
like 5 episodes there.
Well, yeah, they filmed like 8 months of TV there.
Yeah, they filmed about, I want to say realistically without hyperbole, it was probably about 7-8 shows.
Oh God!
Yeah. Well, I gotta ask: is you know what you watch it regularly? Is it any worse than the years they were in the Impact Zone in Orlando?
That's what I was gonna say. It's no different than the Impact Center.
But the Impact Zone is different because that was like their home base.
Okay.
That was like their home base, and they had like it was better lit. Because it was just a soundstage, basically.
And is it any different than when Raw was at Manhattan Center like every week?
Yes,
it is.
It's absolutely different.
How do you think?
Absolutely. Raw
sirens.
Was like,
Raw okay. had sirens. Raw okay. had sirens.
They had sirens.
No, I mean, canned shows from the Impact Zone is one thing because that's their home base. They had a lot of really, they had a really strong fan base there.
And it's studio wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
Literally, exactly. It's in a studio.
Yeah, like, but if you're going to be from New York City, you kind of have to be live.
Okay. I understand, I don't think
any of the shows they're going to be recording is going to be live. No. And I understand why they're not doing live programming, because it's expensive.
Yeah.
I get it.
Yeah.
But if you're going to do that, don't tape 3 months of shows at the same place and pretend like it's live every week. Because when you're in the Impact Zone, like, there's an understanding that comes with that.
Not only that, but the weird schedule they have now. It sounds like a stupid like complaint, but it's weird. I feel like I haven't seen Mike Tenay or Taz for like 8 months because yes. they do all the commentary in house.
Yeah, like, they're not even at the shows.
That's so
and
weird.
And they're still really bad. Like they're live though.
Yeah, and they're trying to do the old joke that Raw used to do back when Raw was recording 2 and 3 shows while Nitro was going live. The commentary would reference something topical, but would have absolutely no place in the storyline. Like, I kind of miss seeing Mike Tenay's face.
Whoa. I miss Mike Tenay's stupid, stupid, angry, sad face.
On the contrary, I don't miss seeing Taz.
Exactly. But Mike Tenay is basically Dennis Hopper in the Mario Brothers movie, and I miss that face. I miss that face so much.
That is the weirdest.
You brought that up.
What?
Oh.
He has an odd lizard face.
And I got
Dennis Hopper.
Okay.
And I got for the.
You made me dry heave there.
Like, we don't see Jeremy Borash anymore, except when he's being slapped around by Ethan Carter. We don't see Christy Hemme anymore. We hear her. We don't see her because she's pregnant. Because
she's popping out the babies.
They're hiding it like The Walking Dead.
And I'm glad that they got a TV deal. I'm glad they're coming back. I am very sincere about that. But it also kind of sucks because one of the best parts about TNA Impact, one of the greatest things that we talked about week in, week out, will not be there for the first set of tapings, and that is Mr. Ethan Carter III.
Probably the second set of tapings, too.
Yeah, so any momentum they could have built off of EC3 and Spud, which they had a lot of, gone.
Yeah, what's Spud going to do now? Like that's
exactly. What is he going to do? Feud of Tyrus for 3.5 months?
British boot camp.
No. But it's just
tags with the winner.
And plus, now they Samoa Joe's vacated the X Division title. Is this new
because of his strain of the
purse strain
contract clause?
Yeah, he strained his PCL. his purse contract ligament. I don't know. And is Bobby Lashley gonna be around? Is he gonna go back to MMA?
One good thing is they don't have Bellator anymore. Bellator,
how dare you?
No. Bellator, it was impact on Spike TV was pretty much a 2-hour commercial for Bellator.
Yeah.
Because all you heard was the next Bellator match. All you saw was a giant corner display of the next Bellator fight. You had Tito Ortiz, King Mo, Rampage Jackson, all trying to be in a angle.
I will say I did enjoy whenever, like when Lashley was running with the belt, how they would mention if he like won an upcoming fight or something like that, and how that would sort of play. Like they would basically treat like that win as like a momentum boost in a pro wrestling world, which I really do enjoy.
Yeah.
But I agree. Yeah, I'm not a huge
fan. And just like Mad Mike said, I'm thrilled to see some of the talent that they have up in TNA. I almost said NXT, and I'm sorry to Dustin, who's probably yelling at his screen right now. Mm-hmm. But TNA has DJZ.
Yes, friend of the show.
He should be the X Division champion. Just pointing that out there. They have Loki, who is actually still pretty damn good for his age. Even though he had wrestled in the initial X Division title match in 2002.
I love that they made that like an emphasis of a thing. He's been wrestling at the bare minimum 14 years.
I hate that because I don't mind them calling back the reference, but they're essentially saying in 12 years, he's in the exact same fucking spot that he was when he came into TNA.
But he's still good. Yeah. He's not good on the mic, as we saw from, you know, NXT and other of that like.
You didn't like that. You didn't like that rap.
I didn't like that rap. But like you said, there's EC3. There's Rockstar Spud, which I've said it many times on this show and on the Midweek War. That angle was the best angle in professional wrestling for a while. Mm-hmm. And it's sad that it has to start all over again because of EC3 being injured. And to see about the numbers, the ratings are going to suck. Yes. Let's point that out. You thought the ratings were bad when they were getting, you know, just barely below a one.
The ratings are going to be what it was like when they were competing directly against Raw.
I don't think
it'll be half of a one.
I don't think it'll matter. 0.5. I don't think it'll matter.
No, not on Destination America.
Yeah, because it's a completely different.
It's gonna beat out the Bacon Show.
They'll be happy just to have a show that does kind of well. You know,
if this show does a 0.5, I think that's blockbuster for where this is.
Destination America,
And this is the kind of thing that could bring enough audience to Destination America, because I mean, you can't say Impact Wrestling doesn't have an audience. It has a very significant audience, I think the wrestling community craps on it because it's obviously not that massive, oh my God, audience that WWE is, right? So there's that comparison factor, but still, it's a significant audience. It feels like TNA has tried to play like they are WWE so much that they try to do WWE things and then fall flat on their face because they don't have a WWE audience, right? Or the WWE marketing muscle or anything like that. Mm-hmm. But bringing that to something like this third tier station does wonders for the station. Mm-hmm. It makes the station a player. And it sounds like they're going to let them do things. Hopefully, you know, and I've had some discussions with somebody that worked with TNA recently about how crappy that relationship was with Spike TV. It's, you know, yeah, we can blame a lot of people at TNA, Impact Wrestling, wherever the F they're called now. But that relationship with Spike TV was not healthy for them. The Bellator thing that you keep speaking to, right? So let's see what they do when they have a different player to play with.
If they have Shark Boy promote United States of Bacon, I'm actually on board for that.
Just Shark Boy stuffing like bacon, like Cookie Monster in his face.
Yes.
Oh, jeez.
Awesome. We're excited for this. Yeah. I'm excited for this. I'm excited for January.
The only thing I'm worried about, it's a long break between shows.
You know what? But one thing I am excited about also, and this was confirmed by one of the producers from the show on Twitter, they're getting new logos. They're getting new colors. Yeah, everything is rebranded from scratch. And I think that's another significant thing. Because even though they've been continuing and they've been trucking along, I think that TNA Impact, what's the name of your company again? Brand has been damaged. From Spike TV, from the people they've had in and out, the revolving door over the years, from the mistakes that have been made, from the sad turnouts at the shows, they need the reboot. You've been like, well, what are they going to do about this and this? Hopefully this means they take things in a new direction straight from scratch.
That's exactly what I was going to ask you. If they change the name, if they change the colors, if they change the color scheme, that's great. What about the story?
Yeah.
What about some of the stuff that's going on? Because I'm just going to point it out right now. MVP isn't cutting it for me.
Mm-hmm.
The knockouts is not cutting it for me.
No, I disagree.
It's not cutting it for me.
Okay.
For me.
But I'm just saying.
It has an audience.
We all have opinions.
But it has an audience.
It has an audience.
Yes. Riz is not the audience.
I know. But I'm just saying, it's not. there's going to be some people who are on my side and some people who are on your side, and it's fine. But all I'm saying is it's fine.
It's fine.
Goddamn motherfucking fine.
But they need a reboot of the Knockouts division. Am I wrong on that?
I'm just saying, like, I'm sitting there. I'm a Destination America person.
Wait, time out. I'm
watching Buying Alaska, and I see a commercial with the Knockouts in it. I think I'm along for the ride.
You see Angelina Love on Destination Alaska?
How many ghost shows could a network have?
If I'm jerking off to When Turkeys Attack, and then suddenly...
Self-basting.
Great fucking show.
Man, wait, will that come on before or after just Buying Hawaii?
Can you imagine the cross-promotion they will do with this? Make sure you stay tuned for Buying Alaska. Make sure you stay tuned after Impact Wrestling tonight for Monsters Underground.
Oh, Monsters Underground. That sounds
I see an Abyss crossover with that.
Chavo, no, he's so big. Don't attack him with that chair.
They'll have the semi-live cut in. You're going to see the Impact ads as the corner roll in front of Amish Haunting. It's
Amish. I might watch this just for the shows that come on after.
I mean, seriously, I'm looking at this, and this is like a parody of a cable network. I can't believe this is for real.
A parody of a cable network.
It is.
Oh my god!
I mean, just with the graphics.
That's a great descriptor.
Just looking at this, it's Ghost Stalkers, Railroad Alaska, A Haunting, Buying Alaska, Ghost Asylum, Alaska Monsters, Monsters Underground, Amish Haunting.
Amish Haunting is when they just get a group of Amish people and put them around the TV.
Swamp
and they
Monsters.
Say, there's a ghost in that box there.
Hillbilly Blood, Mountain Monsters, Buying the Bayou.
Are the Wyatts in there?
I don't know. Wow. Deep Fried Masters.
Yes,
I love that. That is an awesome show.
BBQ, BBQ Pitmasters.
As a fat man, that is an amazing show.
it's everything deep fried, and it's brilliant.
It is awesome. Oh. And there's a deep fried expert and they give out the golden corn dog for the person that wins. Amazing. I highly recommend it.
It continues.
BBQ Pit Wars. Timber Kings. Road to Sturgis.
This is a very
Prepper Hillbillies.
This occasion.
When Ghosts Attack.
What?
I actually saw that once.
Is it like the
not good at all?
Buying RVs.
That's just something you do.
Now you're just boiled down
to everyday activities.
Last call, and finally, Last Call Food Brawl.
Okay.
This sounds like a TNA Thanksgiving. For the Wrestling Mayhem Show, because I think what we're saying here is TNA's got a bright future.
It does. It really does.
Full of ghosts and fried food.
The brightest future of ghosts and fried food.
New show. Ghost corn dogs.
Deep fried ghosts.
Corn dog.
Guys, on that note, please tell me, what did you learn from professional wrestling or Destination America this week? Bobby F. J-Town, what'd you learn?
I learned Chavo needs to leave little people alone. And not attack them with steel chairs.
It's true.
Because they're so little.
Wow. How about you, LB?
And LB powered down.
He's thinking about the fried food.
Corn dog.
Mad Mike, what'd you learn from wrestling this week?
Thank you, Sorg. Thank you. I was going to get a nosebleed.
What did I?
Oh no! Come on.
No. I learned that even I was watching Survivor Series with my sister, and watching a wrestling pay-per-view with someone who does not watch wrestling is perhaps the most entertaining way to watch a pay-per-view. Yep. Because her reactions to things that we know is commonplace is quite humorous. Because she saw the Usos and she's like, who the fuck are these guys? And what are they doing? Then when I told her they're Rikishi's sons, she's like, that makes all the sense in the world. Thank you for explaining it. And she thought Goldust was a different Goldust. And I said, no, that is the same Goldust. And that crazy guy in the red behind him is his brother.
Wouldn't it be great if she's like, the first Goldust, you should have done the old Ultimate Warrior thing. No, the first Goldust is dead and they replaced him.
Oh, no. with a better version of himself.
Exactly. Exactly. Can I, you know what, can I do a what I learned off of that, actually? Because watching a lot of what was I watching? Now I'm blanking on it.
Were you watching Ghost Corn Dogs?
I was watching something from that era of Gold Dust.
Ghost Corn Dogs?
Maybe it was you know what, I think I was just watching the Monday Night Wars. I've seen recently a lot of I was watching old Survivor Series, that's right. Okay. Or Royal Rumbles, actually. And look at Gold Dust. Just go back and watch some Attitude Era Gold Dust. And I can't believe, one, how much better of a wrestler, and two, how much better shape he's in.
DDP Yoga, feel the bang sword.
Ridiculous.
Was, on the network, there was a little intercittle they have on. I've seen it before, but I think they updated it because they started talking about Stardust and stuff like that. It was an intercittle with Goldust and going through his career, and it made me want to know more about Goldust, and like I want them to have an actual DVD special about Goldust.
Dustin Rhodes is a renaissance man.
It's amazing.
Bobby, whatever you do, don't read his book.
Yeah, I won't read his book. But
yeah, no,
I don't read. What the hell, Mike?
His book is not good. His book is not good, but I would appreciate a gold disc.
Books are not good.
Jeez. Riz, what'd you learn?
I learned that John Cena sent out an SOS to the world. And he hoped somebody got his SOS. Because he sent it in a message in a bottle.
What?
Points.
Wow.
Points.
Wow.
Sting answered by Raven.
Sting.
Wow.
What about me?
Lunchbox, have you come up with something yet?
I love how Eamon is the only one who didn't get that reference.
Yep.
Showing us how old we are and how young he is.
Good on.
LB, what'd you learn?
Young and ignorant.
Roxy!
I learned, because I was forced to think about it based off of SummerSlam, that while Sting and The Undertaker would be a sad, depressing garbage match, Sting and Triple H would be something I would tune in to see.
Goddamn right.
That's what I learned.
All right. What about you, Eamon?
Well, I also learned that. I learned that, hey, guys.
Yes.
Rey Mysterio is looking great.
You didn't break anything. That's great.
Booyaka, booyaka, get her done.
He's looking really good.
I mean, it looked like his drug abuse is over now, so that's great.
And he wasn't wearing a knee brace, guys. Let's not get past that. His knees are perfectly fine.
He's still on drugs. He's just turned to pot.
No, pot pies.
I can't wait, and Bobby nailed it. I think the line of the night from last night when that segment happened was Lunchbox going, "I'll be right back, guys. I'll be right back, guys. I'm gonna make some toast and kill myself."
That
toast was so good that it. It was whole. It was whole grain toast with orange marmalade. Fuck
yeah,
that's
so good. It's all really good.
Wow. Did we miss anybody? Did anybody else learn anything?
Wheels didn't say anything in the chat. He just said LMAO.
Okay.
That's what he learned. He learned.
LMAO, not
guys,
even LMFAO.
Thank you so much for joining us here. Another great Wrestling Mayhem show. I hope you enjoy your holiday. Don't forget the hashtag WMS Thanksgiving for a chance to win.
Eamon, it was Sting.
He was referencing Sting in the police song.
Please go check us out. We're at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Subscribe and rate us at iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, YouTube, and iHeartRadio, and other places that you can find podcasts. Somebody let us know if we're in the Xbox Music Store. I heard you can put podcasts in there, or they just happen or something. That's what I heard, but I can't get into it.
We'll be on Spotify soon.
We'll be on Spotify as soon as we can figure out how that happens. You can also drop us a line to Good Time.
Good times
at WrestlingMayhemShow.com.
WrestlingMayhemShow.com.
412-206-WMS0. Please tweet us at Mayhem Show. Look for the Wrestling Mayhem Show on Facebook and Google Plus. And also, please join us here live every Tuesday night at live.sorgatronmedia.com at about 9 p.m. Eastern Time. Please support us on patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow, prowrestlingtees.com/WMS, pittsburghwrestling.com. Thanks to all my friends on the show at Hot Wheels RWA in the chat room. Intern Mike at Mike Allen PR on the Twitter for helping with show notes and tweets all night long. And of course, everybody else here on the show. I'm at Sorgatron, at Mad Mike 4883, at Bobby F. J Town, at Panel Riot, at DE Riz, and at Amon 2. Please check out the End of Mayhem show this week. We'll see you guys next week. Mayhem out. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.